If you were in need, he was there. If you needed advice, he was there. If somebody needed to kick you in the tail and get you motivated, he was there. When we decided this year to do the NHRA Legends and countdown to the 50th anniversary of Gainesville, he was there, heavily involved, right from day number one. We unexpectedly lost him earlier this season at 81 years old, and it was a shock to the racing world when he passed. We certainly could not let the U.S. Nationals pass without paying tribute to one of the greatest to ever drive either a Top Fuel or a funny car. Even though his record as far as NHRA wins doesn't match up with some of the other bigs in the sport, believe me, NHRA would not be where it is today without Tom the Mongoose McEwen's input all those years. Let's take a look up on the big screen and remember an absolute legend.
I like speed and that kind of stuff. And fortunately, I've been able to have a lifetime of doing things that I like to do.
It was the gift of gab and promotional ability that helped make Tom McEwen one of the NHRA's true pioneers. Long before tangling with Perdomo, McEwen was progressing from coupes and alters to dragsters and eventually funny cars. Among his biggest wins was this defeat of Frank Holley during the 84 Big Butt Shootout. In 1991, McEwen was last seen behind the wheel of Jack Clark's Mobile One dragster, his final win coming against Laurie Johns in Englishtown. But it was sponsorship at Mattel in 1970 that made the snake versus the mongoose possible.
We raced each other, and it made something perfectly clear to you. It was for keeps. It wasn't, hey, you go ahead and win this race, I'll win the next one. It wasn't like that. I wanted to beat you every single time.
Their biggest race came in 1978 at the U.S. Nationals shortly after McEwen lost his son.
Tire lane, Tom McEwen. And they're off the line. And Perdomo slips the tires. McEwen pulling ahead. And it is Tom McEwen with the upset of the race. The crew just going berserk.
After hearing of his good friend's passing on Monday, Perdomo added, "We fought like cats and dogs, but we were brothers. I love the guy. As do all of us." Tom the Mongoose McEwen may be gone at age 81, but this is one man no one will ever forget.
The group that chased him around all those years, Pat Galvin, Bob Lukianoff, Tom Prock, many are here this weekend. Rab Kirchner and, of course, Pete Ward, Don the Snake Perdomo down here as we pay tribute. One more time, the car is going to go down the racetrack. This is not a recreation. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the car that Tom McEwen drove down this lane 40 years ago to win the U.S. Nationals. And it's Pat Galvin's son, Trevor, behind the wheel. Please show a little respect as Tom McEwen's actual race car from 1978 takes a nice, easy trip down one of the most historic racetracks in the history of NHRA. As we watch the Mongoose's Corvette parade down the racetrack, Don the Snake Perdomo, I think you've got the same problem I do, a little tear running down the cheek.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. It's a real tearjerker because the guy meant a lot. He meant a lot to the sport. He did so much in it. And like you pointed out, he didn't win all the national events. But I'll tell you what, he won the one that was most important. It was right here in 1978, and it really put him on the map.
I know how competitive you are. You and I have known each other for a lot of years. I think if you look back on the history, as much as you wanted to win every time you got in a car, if there's one that you had to lose, this would probably be it.
No, I'm still pissed about it, to be honest.
I love the man's honesty. You two were a team, and I think you've said it time and again, you wouldn't be here today without the lessons learned from Tom McEwen.
Yeah, that's right. I never gave up a race in my life, and that particular last round, he just I spoke to tires. He just flat beat me. I'm not sure if I could have beat him or not because he ran awfully good that run. But, yeah, I'm still a little pissed about it, but I'm getting over it.
Thank you, sir, for coming out here and being a part of a tribute to the Mongoose. And for those of you who fear that the legend of the Mongoose might die, I am here to assure you that it's never going to happen. The left lane street sign here a few years ago was named in honor of an Indiana legend, Bob Glidden, and I don't think he would mind being joined by another legend as we also dub Indianapolis Raceway Park as Mongoose Street. It might be 50 years from now, but when somebody comes up and says, what's the story of Mongoose Street? The memory of the goose is never going to die here at Lucas Oil Raceway.